I believe that quite possibly the situation could be getting exaggerated on purpose to breed paranoia amongst the American public so that the public will stop fighting against forced government vaccinations. There's a very big fight in America against vaccinations, especially against children, the religious right, everyday parents, black conscious parents, vegan parents. Vaccination is almost like a world war in this country, not a physical violent war, but a strong political war, especially since it was discovered that the measles, mumps, and rebellious shot is triggering autism in black boys. So what better way to get Americans to give up their fight against vaccinations than to scare them into believing that there's so many new diseases on their way, so many viruses, that it would be absolutely in your best interest and in your child's best interest to get vaccinated. So this could be used to force vaccinations on the American people. Number two, it could also be used to force vaccinations as a strategy of population control. So on the first, you just want to vaccinate everybody. But in the second, you want to particularly hone in on African Americans who will go in to get vaccinated. And instead of simply being vaccinated, they will be sterilized, which is something America has a strong history of. We don't have time to go into it now. But when you go back to the eugenics laws in this country, Indiana being the first state to pass a forced sterilization law, 38 states ended up having some form of a forced sterilization law. America used to forcibly sterilize black people who they thought were intellectually impaired, socially impaired, psychologically impaired. They would forcibly vaccinate you. This could be a means to forcibly sterilize black people. Okay? And then the third strategy is that this could simply be used. And then fear is the weapon in all three strategies, by the way. Fear is very useful in a political context. It's very useful. But in the third strategy, it could just be an exercise. Mm. An exercise. A dry run.
Okay.
To see what martial law will look like in America down the road. So let's test the containment strategies. Let's test the hysteria and mass social fear strategy. Let's see how well the American people will follow the guidelines of their states and local governments and what comes from the White House and the federal government. Let's see how the people react to being quarantined and forced to stay in their homes. And if you ask me to order those three suspicions I have with regard to the American outbreak, I would say the dry run on martial law, I think right now, is the most plausible explanation for this exaggeration, because I do believe it's being exaggerated. I hope it's being exaggerated for the sake of our loved ones, right? I believe it's real. Coronavirus is real, but I believe they made it, but I think it's being exaggerated to fulfill certain political ends. And number one, I think the most plausible explanation is a dry run for martial law that is to come. Number two is the sterilization of African Americans. Everybody knows America has been trying to get rid of black folks ever since slavery ended. This would really help America's extermination campaign if they could forcibly get all black people to acquiesce to allowing them and their children to be immunized. And number three, to just kill the vaccination opposition movement altogether so Americans stop fighting against the vaccinations, so America can continue to push that also as a means of social and biological control.